Hey, hey, I'm Dr. Nashley Cephas, and I'm an AI scientist at Amazon Web Services. Today, we're in Seattle, Washington, where we're gonna visit Dog on Seattle, which is an organization that saves dogs just like Stella. I'm also gonna show the owner, Jenny, how to use some generative AI. So come on.
We are a foster-based rescue. Our mission is to save homeless dogs. Every week, we're getting dogs in from high-kill shelters. These dogs are arriving and going to foster care.
What's the difference between fostering and adopting?
So a foster is a temporary home for a dog while they're in transition. The foster home is the most important aspect of our organization because it allows the dog to prepare for adoption so that they can be successful.
How would I become a foster?
You would fill out an application online and we review that. And then we connect you with our foster portal where we work on matching you with a dog. You're just a small bit of time in their life, but crucial to them finding happiness and being alive.
I'm curious, if you had additional help, what would you need help with?
We have a number of things related to delivering information to our community, whether it's our fosters or adopters. When we're sending things in written format, sometimes things get missed. And so having the most valuable resources in an easily digestible format, organized for everybody, that would be huge.
Are you familiar with generative AI?
My personal experience with it is my husband sending memes that are like, this is my daughter, but make her flying on a unicorn with a German shepherd in the sky. I mean, I've heard it talked about, but I don't spend a lot of time thinking about it.
Well, I'd love to show you some generative AI that may be able to help you with your organization.
Sounds good, let's do it.
So PartyRock is our generative AI tool at AWS. It allows you to create apps. It can also upload documents, so you can utilize some of your own data as well. I took the liberty to download a few of the dogs from your website to a PDF, and I created an app that will pick a dog from the Dog on Seattle website download that best match my personality and my lifestyle. So you as the expert, does this make sense for that type of breed? Because you always have to have a human in the loop when you're using generative AI to make sure that the results are accurate.
Based on this, you're gonna take home the German Shepherd that's in my foster yard.
I would love that. I would love to do it.
I can totally see how we could use this tool, especially if we can add some more information. We often get people who apply, but they don't apply for a specific dog. Our case managers are only working with like a small number of dogs. They don't know all the dogs in the organization, so they could put in that summary. And I can see how this would save time.
You've sent over a foster guide PDF, which is about 21 pages long. Mm-hmm. Let's build an app that will take that foster guide and summarize it into smaller bullets. Generate app. Does this look accurate?
Yeah, this does cover a lot of the key points. I can see new fosters use that to get some of their basic questions answered. It's very straightforward, very simple, and I'm excited to dive in and see if I can add more layers and information that could make it really powerful for us.
The more inputs, the more information you give the model, the better and more customized your results will be. Three things I want you to take away. Number one, just start. A lot of people are intimidated by the technology, but you really just gotta get started. Number two, AI is not perfect, so you should always keep a human in the loop. And number three, remember to experiment with the inputs and the parameters of the models to get the output that you want.
Hey, girl.
I'm an AI scientist at Amazon Web Services. Today, we're in Seattle, Washington. Okay.